Welcome back to Fights in Tight Spaces, the Deadly Deal Run, the end game. We could get rid of Deadly Deal at this point, and honestly, in a normal run, I could do that. Like, it is not actually really giving us any benefit at this point. We should ideally be taking little enough damage that its health regeneration aspect should not really be the problem. Instead, what this is posing is a time limit on each of these phases, particularly the last one. Now, I have a reasonable degree of confidence, particularly with the rush of blood, that we should be able to kill the final boss fast enough that Deadly Deal is not going to be what kills us. I think if we die at this point, there is still the risk of that. It is going to be out of place. Being out of place, being in the wrong placement, and maybe using up this emergency move too quickly. Nevertheless, this is a challenge run of sorts, and we need to show this on camera. I don't think Deadly Deal is going to be that much of a problem. So I'm going to get rid of Deep Pockets because there are literally no currency rewards for the rest of the game. Whereas there are still 3 card rewards left in the game, so it's at least theoretically possible that maybe Apprenticeship could do something there. It's very unlikely. For all intents and purposes, this is almost certainly what our deck is going to look like for the entire rest of the game, but you never know. 21 cards is a little bit big for Purist mode, but we have Tactician, of course, which basically makes that not a problem at all. We've got card draw in the form of Foresight and Recall. We have a pretty decent amount of movement and plenty of attacks that move us around. And we have some secret weapons. We've got Grapple and Throw. But I think Taunt could have some excellent tactical use in this battle. So, we've reviewed the stakes of the game. We've reviewed the tools of the trade, the tools at our disposal. Let's go. There's nothing left to do but go. We meet again. Okay, what have we got? We've got Rush of Blood on the very first turn. We have Foresight, which could maybe help us. All things being equal, let's see if we can kill the infantryman. If we can also get close enough to the Renegade Agent, we would be able to get out of the line of the grunt. Maybe we can grapple him or some such. Let's do Foresight first. If we have another thing that moves us or another thing that just does excellent damage to the infantryman, we'll get there. These are not really what I'm after. Recall could be funny, though. I could recall Heavy Strike and Rush of Blood, and honestly, that would be enough. That is funny enough that I'll go with it, and I'm gonna keep the slips for next turn. So I don't know if I'm gonna play the Jump Kick. I'm probably not. But we'll see. Well, I can play the Jump Kick against the Renegade Agent. That's how we do this. So we Heavy Strike. We will Recall now. We will do Rush of Blood. And then I guess we get another... No, the last... So one momentum is going to be spent on this. One momentum is going to be spent on Jump Kick. Yeah. So that's all we're doing. Like, we're recalling Rush of Blood, and it almost doesn't matter what other thing we get. That's it. Alright, so for the sake of argument, commit. Not that I'm gonna use it. So Rush of Blood, again, makes us a 30 damage Jump Kick. And he's trying to do 35 to us, but it doesn't matter because I'm gonna grapple him over here so that he gets hit for 24 by his buddy. Okay, that's a pretty good start. I'm gonna just call that pretty good. Sure. You can get thrown. Might as well play it on you. You'll dodge the front kick, and then we'll just punch him in the face. So much for the first mission. That's more or less how I expected that one to go. What have we got? Rising Strength is intriguing. And it's upgraded Rising Strength. That could pay dividends. Just fish for that as early as possible. We could pay for that. And just get our... just get some even more just automatic damage modifier. And that would scale pretty darn quickly. Yeah, we could fish for that with Foresight. That's probably okay. It will get out of our deck after we play that. I think we can stand to draw that and play that. We've upgraded our movement enough that we can probably fit that in. That's probably reasonable. I think skipping it would be reasonable too, but, you know, I think this is a last-minute addition that I think we can probably bear with. I'm gonna try it. It might get me in a little bit of trouble, but part of the reason I took that is because I also have emergency moves. So in an emergency, if somehow Rising Strength messes me up, the opportunity cost of drawing that made my hand too poor, I can emergency move out of the way. And if it doesn't, I save the emergency move for later. Okay, who needs to die? Somebody. We can hit and run on you. It's gonna depend a little bit on which direction you go, though, so maybe I need to attack you more. Like, I actually probably just want to kill you, then. Let's Foresight and see what we get. Let's not play Rising Strength quite yet. Maybe it's not quite time. Front kick will work. That's good enough. Do we counter stun? Do we perfectly counter the ninja's kick and stun him for next turn to finally get some use out of this thing? Yeah, I could have probably actually remembered to remove that. Yeah, that might have actually been better than upgrading my slip and shift if I remember to move that. But, oh well. It's not completely useless, though, as we have just found. Alright, you get off my plane. That's right, it's my plane. It's not Agent 11's, it's my plane. So we can't both counter stun and play Rising Strength. So that's the issue. It's either counter stun and heavy strike to do a respectable 20 damage. Not an amazing 20 damage, but a respectable amount. Or just very slowly gain plus 2 damage modifier. I think I'm actually not interested. I'm in a hurry. I want to rush you down and kill you as fast as possible and then deal the 45 damage to you. Just so that I don't have to deal with you on the final mission. If I can kill both of the lieutenants for the final mission, then all I need to do is kill you and you're like one guard. And I can just focus on that, and that'll speed that one up. That's the one mission I'm worried about the time limit, if any. Like, if you think about it, this is like a 15-turn time limit if I decide not to take any damage, which is plenty. So, I will just try and get some damage on you now. That's enough. That's all I really need to do. And as a bonus, I'm right there, right on all next to you. So I can do whatever I like to you. I could recall. What would be some fun things to recall? I could just take the Rising Strength now. Or I could just take more attacks. How many attacks do I actually need to kill you? Not that many, as it turns out. So I think I'm fine with just recalling the Rising Strength. Just get that out of the way now. So, don't need to worry about drawing that in the future. I don't know which of these other things I'll need, so I guess I'll just take another front kick. I'm more likely to use that than a Foresight, I think. So play that now. And with two more momentum besides, I'm just playing both of them against you and calling it a day. And front kick actually does work. Yeah. I could have slipped and jumped kicked, but this saves me a little tiny bit of combo. Alright. I got done what I wanted to get done. And I guess I want to get closer to you. Yeah, it's still possible that I draw either the taunt or the throw, and if I draw the throw, I do want to be close to you. So, I'll move up by one. So now I end the turn up here, rather than, well, here, rather than here. Okay. Oh, you're gonna try and summon a friend, huh? Oh, you don't really need to summon a friend. What do you need external help for? Okay. There's not much I can do here other than commit. Rush of blood, naturally. And then throw him down to the ground. Oh yeah, and I have shock, too. Not affected by damage modifiers, which is a bit of a shame, but, the only reason that it would be not affected is, I guess, because you could throw multiple enemies at a time and hit them all with the damage modifiers, but even then, like, if you can manage that, I'd almost argue that you should be allowed to use the damage modifiers on them. Like, that should be what makes this such a good card. But I guess it's, consistent with, like, Flash Powder or Caltrops, I guess. Oh, well. And Flash Powder, at least, does have slightly more, argument towards, making that an issue. Okay, so we have Grapple. We also had Emergency Move, so we can just kill him, so... The fact that he is trying to do 39 damage to us is of no concern. We'll do 39 damage to him. Alright, so much for that mission. Do I want change of heart? Cruddy Ponder. I think not. We don't want broad shoulders. This is about the time in the game where it stops being good. And this is not our build. 8 damage for 1 momentum? Get out of here. We can do better. Not activating auto attacks would be nice against this guy, but we have better things to do. If we're at melee range to him, we don't want to be nerf striking him. We want to be just pummeling him with our even higher damage attacks. Sure. Yeah, grapple. Alright. Why don't you two have at it? Jump kick this guy in the back of the head. Come to think of it, I could have played counter stun, recall counter stun, and I think if I got next to him, I would have stunned him twice. So that could have been cool, and I just didn't think of it fast enough. Oh well. This is amusing enough anyway, and I get 25 bonus damage on him from the boss, so I think it's okay. What are we recalling here? Maybe just commit and jump kick again? Honestly, that would be fine too. Feels like a little bit of a waste. You know the one thing I'm really disappointed in? We didn't get a flash kick this whole game. Oh man, imagine that. Like, jump kicking somebody, flash kicking them, and then jump kicking them again. Oh man, that would have been glorious. So many missed opportunities in this run, and yet, so many landed opportunities. We're making use of what we've got, that's for sure. How much health do you have? 15. I know how to solve that problem. Rush of blood. Now my 2x3s turn into 7x3. Okay. I could taunt you. And then that would let me approach you safely. Have you got your eyes examined? No? Should have. Okay, so yeah, despite that looking like a bump, we didn't actually take any bump damage there. He is trying to summon a friend. I don't think we can get over there to stop him, not unless I want to take a ridiculous amount of damage. However, maybe we want to take a ridiculous amount of damage. I mean, he's just gonna counter me for 30. Pshaw. I can take that. That's no problem. It's fine. It's fine. Ow. Look, it's fine. See? No problem. Like to see you get medical care up here. No hospital on this plane. But we'll just regenerate our flesh and keep on going. This is tempting. But no, no. Our deck works. No. We will set such things aside. We don't need them. For we have the deadly deal on our side. Alright, it's just you and me and your army of infinite goons. And if I have something to say about it, it's going to quickly turn into a finite army of goons. Alright, get things started right out of the gate. Get in the damage while we can. I don't really care that much about attacking this guy now. I'm probably just gonna clean him up with some incidental attack later on. And it's actually good to have him around, because he's somebody that I could front kick or jump kick to get away from you later on. And keeping him around means I can do amusing stuff like that. Oh, well, there went all my movement. That's fine. Let's play the Rising Strength now. I think that makes sense. Like, maybe we just don't attack him much this turn. That's okay. We'll just play the Rising Strength now. Get that all taken care of. What do we want to recall? We don't have that much that's exciting to recall. I think we just keep the recall. I think we just don't need it. Yeah, just go kill this guy. I mean, we have to kill him eventually anyway. Might as well do it now. Things have lined up so that it makes sense. One fewer thing to do later. I know I just got done saying that it would be very useful to have him, but, you know, I can change my mind whenever I like. And you can't stop me. No one can stop me. What do we got next turn? We've got Taunt and Unleash and Rush of Blood. Ooh, that's a fancy combination. So the way I want to play that out, then, is I don't want him to be adjacent to me next turn. I want to be exactly 4 tiles away from him. So I'm going to step right here. And I'm just going to wait. Oh, that's fine. It's just another grunt. See? It's a good thing I killed the first one, then. Hey, you want to show off your 3-punch combo for me? Thanks. So that means that now I can just approach him. I don't have to worry about him. I'm gonna supercharge him, but he's not gonna attack me this turn. Oh, but you better bet I'm gonna attack him. Okay, give me some more cards. Let's build up my combo. I want to unleash properly on him. Recall. Yes. We're not gonna take the double jump kick. I can't use it unless I emergency move. How insanely ridiculous do we want to go in on this? I don't think it will work out that well. Like, I can't play unleash and double jump kick and recall, so we'll save this for later. We don't quite have enough momentum to be that aggressive. It's not that crazy. So I want the slip next turn, so throw. Okay, we'll end the combo with a throw. and we'll play the shock, I guess. I mean, there's probably something better we can do with one combo or one momentum. Not really. I don't want a foresight with that one momentum, so I think I'm just going to take Rush of Blood again, left spin kick again, and then unleash and throw in shock and all that. Okay. That is entirely reasonable. That is a good use of recall. If we're gonna Rush of Blood again. Sure. We're going all in on this. Plus 14 damage modifier. Unleash for 23 times 3 damage. Throw for 26. And shock for 15. Okay, that's pretty good. He's at 30 health now. So much for the time limit. Now he's in his less aggressive mode where I can work around him that much easier, but hey, would you look at that. Okay, good fight. 5 turns. I've beaten him faster than that, but most of them have either involved tackling him out of this void square or completely, utterly, like, even more ridiculous decks than this one. Or, like, going infinite, for example. So for a pretty standard Rush of Blood deck, aggression, hammer fist, jump kick, all that good stuff, 5 turns, pretty good. Pretty solid work, if I do say so myself. Alright, job well done. I don't really need any of this stuff. It's the end of the game. You should just be giving me a monetary reward. Skip. Thanks. I'm looking forward to, just sitting in my house, drinking tea, losing 3 health a turn. It's fine. I guess we can go to the hospital. Maybe. Pretty good score. What I'm interested in is the average turns per fight, 4.1. Wow. I'm impressed. Usually that's starting to hover more around, like, 5 or 6, but that just speaks to the utter out-of-the-gate monstrosity that this deck was, because, this doesn't really ramp up so much. Like, we got a little bit of that with, Rush of Blood, certainly. I've had decks that involved a lot more than that, like, Palm Strikes, those power sinks that we saw earlier, things that started out much slower and ramped up to become much more absurd. This was just heavy damage out of the gate. 20 damage for one, 14 damage for one. A scaling amount of damage that eventually usually became around like 20 damage for one. And it just kept going up from there. Recall and foresight were actually huge force multipliers for this whole thing, but grapple and taunt was good all game long. Wasn't always good on every single turn we drew it, but a lot of the turns we drew it, it was pretty solid. Got some work in. Absolutely can be a good defensive measure, much like all these other ones, and I think it was about as good as a dodge. I think that's quite saying quite a lot. So, pretty neat. Not as hard as I would have thought. I'm gonna be honest with you, I think my draft was good way back at the start, and we just kept getting good snowballing effects, good cards, good additions, good enhancements certainly. Tactician absolutely also played a huge role in making this deck what it was. And apprenticeship too. But we just kept making good decisions all the way through, kept, you know, steadily doing things one at a time. And I got to demonstrate a few ways in which taking some hits on purpose speeds things up. That ended up being a lot less of a theme later on with Rush of Blood, but by that time, like, our deck was so well developed that, like, we were not taking the hits as much because we were killing our enemies. So there you have it. That's Deadly Deal. We didn't wind up getting Iron Body. Where is that? Yeah, we didn't end up getting this. This is like a classic combination with Deadly Deal. Easy sustainability for that. Where's Blood Fury? Also a good combination there. Take 6 damage. Don't have to worry about the long-term effects of that. This is a good one for Deadly Deal. There's some others there that are not quite as inspiring. There is that one where, like, you take damage and you get, like, modifier for this turn. I'm not sure where that is, but we saw it earlier. Okay. So there's a lot of different ways you can build that. You can build that defensively. You can have Deadly Deal on a counter deck, although not my favorite way of playing it, but you could play it that way. You don't have to worry about taking damage from enemies as much. It's just a time limit then, and you get sustainability. And you don't have to worry about perfect countering enemies as much. You can just do the counter attacks, and it's okay if you take some incoming hits. But I think this is the classical, the archetypical Deadly Deal deck. Get a whole bunch of attacks, kill your enemies as fast as humanly possible, and just go to town. Alright, well that'll do it for Fights in Tight Spaces. Next time, it might be the DLC. We'll see. But, I don't know, if you want me to record some more daily plays, I'll think about it. If you want me to do other challenge runs in new game, I'll think about it. So, I'll see you later for whatever the next project is. Thanks for watching.